great scientist, he said that a child without a board without wings is like a child without education is like a board without wings. Isn't that true?
Yes.
Yes, that's definitely absolutely true. And now coming to the education system of India, there are many merits and demerits in the education system in our country. Let us see. And the education system is divided into two categories, the ancient time and the modern time. In the ancient time, will be like, it is also known as the Gurukul system. Means the teacher is in his home and the students should go up to his house and be with him and study as long as he or she educated. Means the education about the life skills and the cultures. And this is the oldest system. Now it has got modified and this was changed as the present system. We are having so many we are having technology to improve the skills of the students. And in India, the government school started in 1921. It was first started in Uttar Pradesh, in our country. And afterwards, there are so many government schools and private schools that started. And now we are here studying. That means the education system is perfect. And now this is an act called the Article 21A, which was introduced in the year 2009. Means the right to education. Means in our country, every child should get educated. And this helped so many members to get. Means it helped so many members to get educated, and the child labor got increased. And these are some demerits that we see here. Means in so many government schools or colleges, there is a problem called the poor toilets. Means there is no facility for a toilet. And some of the government schools have only 28% schools have only computers, and remaining 9% of them are having the internet facilities. Rest of all not having anything. And 31% of the teachers. 21% of the teachers not having their own degree. And the system in this is the only mock-up. Means there is no proper attention on the skills. Means this is not the correct way. Means the student is addicted only for the studies and there is no time for him to spend with the family members and for playing. Means there is no time to develop his or her own skills. And the very thing in our education system is that like education is cheap in our India. Means everybody can access the education. And the introduction of Article 21A in the year 2009, due to that, the child labor got increased. And this, my ideology on this is this: how we can have a proper education system in our India. That is, that we need to embrace the skill based system, but not marks based system. And we need to embrace the innovative thinkers, and we need to develop an ideal guide to innovative thinkers. And the teacher should be smart as well. Then thank you.
My question is